you're a no.
Mike Lozada.
Okay, first we have public comment. The Penn Ridge School Board welcomes public comment. According to policy 903, we remind everyone of the following. Public comment shall be limited to 3 minutes unless otherwise specified by the board. Participants must be recognized by the presiding officer and with their name and municipality. All statements shall be directed to the presiding officer rather than to individual board members, district employees, or members of the public. A speaker may speak once during each comment period. Please note that these sessions are designated for comments to protect the confidentiality and privacy rights of all members of our community. The board encourages members of the public to direct any comments regarding particular individuals, such as students or district employees, private legal superintendent, or other appropriate administrators or board members, or to communicate with the board and superintendent by sending an email to psdschoolboard@penridge.org. Questions raised and not addressed may be followed up at a later time. Here, or we can come up and handle it.
Iowa Esposito, East Rockville Township. Good evening. Tonight, I wanted to put politics aside, past grievances and real disagreements behind us, and highlight the outstanding service of one particular board member. Dr. Peter Garnell has served this district as a member of our school board since 1991. His 28 years of service to the district, longer than I have been alive, are a model for all who seek to serve their community or who desire to do better. He has served as president of the school board for 11 of those years, chairing multiple committees, including the Joint Operating Committee of the Upper Bucks County Technical School, and for more than 20 years on the curriculum committee. His original motivation for running was the desire to improve the mathematics curriculum, but his service was above and beyond that money. For the past year, it has been my privilege to work with him, and I have been continually inspired by his honesty, his integrity, and his genuine desire to see our district thrive. I grew up and I graduated in those years of his service. I will forever be a better citizen because of Dr. Garnell. I urge every member of our community to come together in light of his service to our district and reflect on how we can best serve Penn Ridge. Thank you for your time.
Next is Cindy Zenzo.
Zunzel. I was an employee with the district in the kitchen for the past 9 years and 3 years prior to that. Recently, I have had a problem with the elementary school I worked at. I got a fungal infection from the school, which the school refuses to pay my medical bills. I have a bag of the fungus with me. I would like to know if anybody on this board would like to take this fungus and rub it on their legs and on their chest and their stomach and see what happens to them.
Ms. Hansel, I'm afraid that personnel matters the board cannot respond to, but I would simply ask you to see Ms. McHale after the meeting and talk to her.
I want my medical bills paid.
I understand that, Ms. Hansel.
And I want my pain and suffering. I was a good employee to this district, and there was a lot of problems in that kitchen that were never addressed.
Thank you, Ms. Hudson.
Sue Frodo.
Sue Frodo, West Rockville Township. I've been attending board meetings and committee meetings since 2008. I was elected to the board in 2009 and served for 4 years, just to get that out there. And since my tenure on the board ended, I've attended probably 90 to 95% of the committee meetings and the board meetings. I won't pretend to know everything that goes on, you know, but I do keep track as closely as possible. We have a new board coming in. Well, I say new. We have a number of incumbents. And I just wanted to say that when I began watching the board, there was no respect for the taxpayers' money. The first thing I saw was that there was no bidding going on for hardware or services. I know services are slightly different, but it was a project that was projected to be over $1 million with no bids. They bid it out and they saved $500,000. That was one of my very first exposures to how the board was being run at the time. I got involved because there was a lawsuit against the tax collectors. For some strange reason, this board collectors' jobs and, of course, the compensation that they got. We spent $150,000 on that fiasco, and we lost at the state Supreme Court. Taxes are to be collected by tax collectors. I saw where we had a member on the Facilities Committee who was rewarding or awarding work to a spouse, and the spouse was doing it at a profit. And the leadership of the board at that time knew it, said that he knew it, and allowed it to go on. That is an insult to the public. Then we have an Articles of Agreement of the Joint Operating Committee at the Upper Fox Tech School. I found out, listening to a video, that since 2007, I believe, we have had gentlemen's agreements. I'm sure the statute of limitations has expired. I wonder how much Enbridge tax money got spent inappropriately for other districts' students. It's a lack of respect for our money. And if you are a long-term member of the Joint Operating Committee, then, and you don't think the formula is fair to all three sending schools, you don't come up with a gentleman's agreement. You amend the articles and fix it.
Just for a purpose or a position that was parliamentary, and I was equal.
No, that's fine.
Just ask.
You were speaking.
So,
okay, perfect.
Good evening, my name is Linda Ziegler. I'm a power educator here at Pembridge High School. I want to thank you for the opportunity that you give us to speak here regarding our issues. I wanted to just bring up one thing regarding our contract and maybe a different way of looking at it. About 14 years ago, I attended a parents and community event at Penn Central Middle School, and the speaker was from Alaska. He spoke on the topic that it takes a village to raise a child. He spoke about the high suicide rate in Alaska, teenage suicide rate, I'm sorry, in Alaska, and how the community needed to take a stand to take a different effect on them. He expressed that each person in their community took a role in their lives, and that the teens there started they started a program for the teens there that was called It Takes a Village to Raise a Child. I understand that a lot of your decisions come from a business standpoint, and my husband is a business owner in the community, so I certainly do understand that. But I also wanted to ask you to take a different perspective, to look at the services that we provide to education, to the students and the families of the community that we make things happen for them each day. The point, I guess, that we don't need to really worry about sometimes is we're not really in a battle with each other, and we don't need to lose a battle to each other, but we want to make sure that we don't lose a student. I would want to invite each and every one of you to visit what we do. I would be honored if one of you could shadow me, or I don't know, a bus driver or a nurse or anyone else, a secretary would, you know, object to that. I'm not speaking for everyone. I just know for me that we do a lot in the lives of students and their families. As someone said before, you know, maybe that student that had a rough start to the morning came in and they've been out in rehab for months, and the first person they see is their bus driver or the secretary where they have to sign in. Maybe they're so behind in their academics that the teacher initially gives them the work, but the teacher has to concentrate on the rest of the class. So we tutor them in the classroom to get them back to where they need to be productive in the school community. Just think about it. Like I said, I invite any of you to come out. So willing, I know some of you personally. I've served with you in our community on PTAs, on sports booster clubs. That's it.
Serving on the board for 28 years is a huge commitment. We do have a recognition for him in terms of certificate and a plaque. I'm going to be meeting with him next week. We have a time to meet people to come together to meet with some of the cabinet members and for us to be able to present that for him. So we want to at least thank him. Are there any other board members or cabinet members who want to say something?
I've just been thinking about how he's very involved with his grandchildren. He's always with them, taking them places. I've been thinking about how I think his grandchildren are going to appreciate that he's able to be with them even more. So I'm looking forward to that. And I appreciate his trust. It is a long time, your whole lifetime, being a volunteer student or whatever. So that is pretty remarkable.
I was just going to say, Dr. Yarnell gave me always a different perspective. I used to sit next to him up here. We had grandparent stories, actually, and grandfather as well, so we share that. And Alvin Allen, he's a good guy. We had lots of good conversations, a wealth of knowledge that he brought to the board. So I appreciate his 28 years of service. Just a good guy.
The Pennsylvania School Board Association, if you remember earlier in the year, they were here to recognize him for his 28 years of service. They put out a monthly bulletin that's actually called the Bulletin, that they list in the fall the school board members by length of service. And so I have a copy for Dr. Yarnell that we're going to give him, but when you look up his length of service, there's only about 20 people in the United States who have been serving their local school boards longer than he had. One person, I think the maximum is 40 right now, in terms of there's one person. So I know that he's not here, but I'll force him to at least watch this 15 seconds of the ceremony. So if we could just give him a round of applause, I know that we could do that. Social and emotional
Students looked at lists of activities and checked the ones that fit them best, then took a personality test to determine their dominant strengths. From there, they were given suggestions for careers that matched their dominant personality traits. The goal is to spark an interest in what they might want to do in the future. Spark days will happen throughout the year and are integrated into the everyday curriculum. And next, we move on to the superintendent's report.
Thank you. My section of the meeting is going to be all about the talented students and adults of Cambridge, since there's lots of people here who we want to recognize. So first, I'm going to start with some sets of our student athletes. So this time of year, we celebrate our student athletes who qualified for state competition. So the first group that we're going to recognize is a congratulation to the girls' soccer team on an outstanding, amazing season. Second year in a row that they have gotten at least that deep in the state playoffs. So ladies, congratulations.